I studied culinary at Sheffield College. I left and went to Jersey and worked at Longville Manor, which was my first sort of work experience, work placement, and then followed on that to a job. I did 4 years there before moving to Germany and doing 2 years in Germany at a 2 Michelin star. It was definitely up another level. It was really, you know, 2 stars of the establishment's now a 3-star Michelin. So we were really sort of pushing forward and a different sort of feel to what we were doing in Jersey, that's for sure. I then made a big decision to move to America. I worked in another L.A. and Chateau property on the east coast of America for 4 years. And then in 2004, got the job here at Summer Lodge. It's a lovely property to work at. The owners are great and very generous with what we're allowed to do. Pretty much the menu is left to us in the kitchen. So the dish we're going to produce today, we've titled just simply Dorset Lamb. And then we're going to drill it in a little bit deeper and take a couple of the prime cuts and a couple of the sort of lesser known cuts and maybe stuff that people are a little bit more afraid to use at home. So we're going to do a breast of lamb, which we're going to cook in the water bath. So we're going to completely debone it. We're going to make a farce out of some lamb trimmings, stuff that with some dried apricots and rosemary, roll up the lamb breast, tie it in cling film, and then that cooks for 12 hours in the water bath. We're going to use a sweetbread as part of the dish. So again, we're just going to blanch those, panny those and deep fry them. And then from the prime side, we're going to take the loin off the saddle, cook that just simply in the water bath, and also the fillet from the underside of the saddle. And we're going to put a little Kalamata olive crust on that and just grill that as well. And then just simply with a little bit of Mediterranean vegetables in the form of a nice fine ratatouille, a fondant potato, and a slow cooked tomato petal, which has been dried over wild garlic pesto. Try and get the most out of what we've got, and the prime cuts are great and everybody wants to see them, but everybody also gets a little bit excited when they can see something that they maybe had in their childhood, like the breast of lamb, or that they wouldn't attempt at home because it is that bit more daunting, if you like. I think everybody likes the local story and the reducing food miles element of it. Even in the past sort of 10 or 12 years, we notice even more people are keen to think that they're doing their bit as well, and that we're not dragging stuff in from halfway around the world just for the sake of it. We do a menu to support British Food Fortnight where we sort of say the menu's 100% Dorset. And again, we're then literally just buying everything in from the local guys from literally within Dorset and produce a full 7-course tasting menu that is 100% Dorset. When creating a dish, certainly for us here, we try not to overcomplicate it. I think 3 or 4 flavours on a plate is enough to create a nice balanced dish without overcomplicating it. Even though with the lamb dish we've got 4 different cuts of meat, we've actually only working with 2 or 3 different flavours. We've got the Mediterranean vegetables, we've got the olives for a bit of saltiness, and we've got the meat.